all over the world. I've seen grandchildren of slave masters tearing down slave master statue over in England and put it in the river. I'll pour out my spirit among all flesh. I've seen whites walking past curfews saying no Black Lives Matter, no justice, no peace. I'll pour out my spirit among all flesh. You have now lived to where you've sown wickedness, and now you have to reap the wrath of those that don't want to be wicked no more. That a man sows, that shall he also reap. So we come because God, in his own way, he always, one of the ministers said it right, God always uses unlikely people to do his will. If George Floyd had been an Ivy League school graduate and one of these ones with a long title, we would have been accused of reacting to his prominence. If he'd been a multimillionaire, they would have said that we were reacting to his wealth. If he had been a famous athlete, as he was on the trajectory to be, we would have said we were reacting to his fame. But God took an ordinary brother from the third ward, from the housing projects, that nobody thought much about but those that knew him and loved him. He took the rejected stone, the stone that the builder rejected. They rejected him for jobs. They rejected him for positions. They rejected him to play certain teams. God took the rejected stone and made him the cornerstone of a movement that's going to change the whole wide world.